Hello, and welcome to Eaton's Power Systems Experience Center in Houston, Texas. In this video, we'll show you some design considerations for electrical systems in multi-tenant units by walking you through our own high-rise application. We're going to follow the power flow, starting at distribution and continue down to the receptacle. Along the way, we'll also identify any national electrical code or NEC requirements that are satisfied within the space. As you design and build high-rise applications, know that Eaton solutions enable you to ensure safety features needed to meet NEC while maintaining reliability and efficiency. Now, let's go follow the power. Let me give you a sense of how far power must travel in high-rises. The observation deck of the Empire State Building is almost a quarter mile high. In order to provide efficient power at that height, the industry standard is to distribute power via busway. The reason is because when compared to cable and conduit, busway provides greater efficiency, is easier to install, and voltage drop is considerably lower, making it much more cost effective. Here we've installed the PowerWay 3 1200 amp busway, which has all of the features just mentioned and provides an interrupt rating of 200 kiloamps. This model is also equipped with infrared joy covers, allowing you to record thermal readings for preventative maintenance without having to de-energize the busway. Preventative maintenance lets you track conditions over time, identifying irregular thermal readings. Next up in a system like this is a group metering main, which is an enclosure that exclusively houses a main circuit breaker. Here we've installed a 1200 amp breaker to match the ratings of the busway conductor. And because of this 1200 amp breaker rating, it falls under NEC 240.87, which requires that if a breaker is rated or can be adjusted to 1200 amps or higher, it must be able to reduce arc flash energy. The code also identifies seven ways of going about this, which are zone selective interlocking, differential relaying, energy reducing maintenance switching with local status indicator, energy reducing arc flash mitigation system, an instantaneous trip setting that is less than the available arcing current, an instantaneous override that is less than the available arcing current, and last, an improved equivalent means by an authority having jurisdiction, AHJ. Eaton's power defense breakers come integrated with Eaton's arc flash reduction maintenance system, or ARMS, which enables circuit breakers to be compliant with the code falling under the energy reducing maintenance switching with local status indicator, accepted means of protection. As required by code, ARMS can be engaged directly on the trip unit's face, and it provides a visual status indication. Keep in mind that in order to achieve full compliance with NEC 240.87, the system must undergo performance testing in order to verify safe installation. One means specifically called out in the code is primary current injection. However, the NEC also allows the AHJ to approve other testing methods. One such method is the secondary injection testing with power defense breakers that can be performed by simply plugging into the USB port, whether the breaker is energized or not. As we continue to follow the power flow, the next solution in this system is the surge protection device, or SPD. And per NEC Article 230.67, SPDs are required for all services that supply power to dwelling units. This article was adopted due to the need to protect life safety devices that are installed in dwelling units such as smoke alarms and AFCI breakers, to name a few. Part B of the article identifies that SPDs must be integrated into the service equipment or immediately next to it. This allows for installation either at the switchboard, immediately after the group metering main breaker, as we've done here, or in the dwelling unit load center. If an SPD is installed in the service equipment, then no further SPDs are required downstream. We've now reached the metering stack section of the power system, and every project will vary based on application and local utility requirements. Most systems will be a combination of these following stacks. The first stack is equipped with a 400 amp socket and is a three-phase in and out stack, commonly used for commercial retail tenants on the ground floor, a restaurant or nail salon, for example, but can also easily feed a lighting or mechanical load. However, this same stack can also be engineered for single phase if needed. The benefit is that we can still size up the 400 amp sockets, satisfying local utility requirements, but also do it within a smaller footprint. This next meter stack has 200 amp meters, which can be rated down to 125 amps. This provides greater flexibility and that you can provide a single unit with both service sizes. the stack will commonly be used to service large 2 to 3 bedroom units or townhomes. This last stack is 125 amp meter version and is a typical service size for most dwelling units. Oftentimes, the distance between these stacks to the load center downstream will result in voltage drops. To account for this, clients can upsize the cable between service points, but it will require 200 amp stacks. As an alternative solution, Eaton offers a 4-watt lug adapter that is the same size as a 2-watt lug adapter. This solution allows clients to upsize 4 out of the 5 sockets and continue design with 125 amp meter stacks. Our group metering stacks are built here in the US. If you're a distributor or a contractor, know that Eaton can also accommodate customization as needed. With the electrical industry transitioning towards digitalization within group metering, Eaton is prepared to meet the challenge with digital metering solutions. The application here utilizes a Busway mounted main breaker and a switchboard to minimize footprint. The solution allows facility managers to track and accurately allocate energy usage among tenants, thereby meeting local energy codes. With accurate energy information, facility managers have the data needed to make intelligent energy saving decisions. The U.S. does not currently have a national energy code. However, most states and municipalities are adopting the American Society of Heating, Refrigerating and Air Conditioning Engineers, or ASHRAE standard 90.1. This standard serves as a guide for the energy efficient design of buildings and requires a system design approach by separating loads into 5 categories: total energy usage, interior lighting, receptacle usage, HVAC system, and exterior lighting. In order to meet standard 90.1, Eaton offers various power meters, one example being Eaton's Power Expert multi-point meter, which can capture, quantify, and help benchmark energy usage in a wide range of applications. Along with energy usage, this meter can also monitor other utility services like water and gas to manage facilities' entire utility footprint. Another electrical component that all high-rise applications will need to account for are elevators. High-rises by design require elevators which are controlled by disconnect switches like this one. Their installation and operation are overseen by several code models which create complexity. To give you an idea, these are the different model codes that impact elevator installation. NFPA 70, which is the National Electrical Code, NFPA 72 governs the National Fire Alarm Code, NFPA 13 looks at design and installation of sprinkler systems, and the ANSI A17.1, which ensures elevators are safe for use. Each one of these codes will have an effect on the type of elevator disconnect switch that can be installed. Eaton's elevator control switch complies with each of those codes, providing an all-in-one solution. As seen here, this model also has an integrated SPD, providing compliance with NEC 620.51E. which states that emergency system loads must be protected by a surge protection device. Keep in mind that this SPD is required regardless if there's an SPD installed in the distribution equipment. Moving into the unit, we've now reached the load center. Unlike a single family home, multi-tenant load centers can either be series rated or fully rated. Eaton's overcurrent protection devices are capable of series rating from the group metering main to the tenant main to the load center. Series rating is a combination of 2 or more breakers connected in series, where the interrupting current rating of the downstream device is less than the interrupting current rating of the system. For example, a load center that is rated at 10 KIC, because its branch breakers are rated at 10 KIC, can be placed in series with an upstream tested breaker combination and series rate the load center to 22 KIC. Essentially, the circuit will be interrupted safely at least once, even with a lower AIC rated circuit breaker. This translates into a lower cost and a smaller footprint, allowing the use of load centers instead of panel boards. You'll remember that NEC 230.67 covers the requirement of surge protecting devices in dwellings, requiring that SPDs be installed at the service equipment. However, the exception is if the next level distribution equipment downstream towards the load has an SPD installed. So if the SPD is not installed at the switchboard or group metering main upstream, then the SPD must be installed in the unit load center. Again, the primary objective of 230.67 is to protect sensitive life safety devices like fire alarms, smoke alarms, and AFCI breakers. Downstream from the unit load center, these two receptacles are some of the safety devices SPDs are intended to protect. GFCI and AFCI receptacles. These receptacles in turn protect end users in wet locations and in the event of a fire. Let's discuss ground fault circuit interrupters first. NEC 210.8 requires all receptacles between 125 to 250 volts installed in or near wet locations be GFCI receptacles. GFCI breakers and receptacles ensure electric shock protection in areas where electricity may come into contact with water, such as kitchen countertops and bathrooms. GFCIs protect by immediately breaking the circuit when electrical current leakage is detected, reducing the risk of shock and electrocution. Article 210.12d identifies rooms be protected with arc fault circuit interrupters or AFCI, such as bedrooms, kitchens, and closets. AFCIs provide protection by monitoring the electrical circuits for the presence of arcing conditions. Once an AFCI receptacle or breaker recognizes an arc fault, it will quickly trip to stop the flow of electricity, preventing the electrical system from being an ignition source of a fire. As we've discussed throughout this video, there are many code requirements, design options, and new technologies to take advantage of if you are involved in designing or building the electrical system for multi-tenant high-rise buildings. If you want to learn more about multi-tenant high-rise options or discuss your next high-rise application, contact us or your local Eaton sales rep to schedule a visit to one of our Eaton Power Systems Experience Centers.